presents this woman.
Her mother and I.
Thank you.
Is it on?
Yeah, it is. So the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also here.
Right. Dear family members of the Short and the Vogel family, dear relatives and friends, you're heartily welcome to this special service today. Dear Margo and Jay, you decided to commence an adventure which will last your whole life through. but you both love adventures. We can see that on your common hobbies, the trekking and mountain climbing. But contrary to that, to your climbing and hiking tours, matrimony's goal is not to stop on the top of a mountain or a special viewpoint. Its purpose is to stay together till the end of your lives. Jesus Christ has promised us and you to be with you, to be with us every single day till the end of the world. Therefore, we gathered here today to pray for God's blessing for your common path of life. And we want to thank God that you came together, pray for you, and to listen to the words of the Lord. So let's pray together. God our Father, Margo and Jay promised in the face of you and in the presence of this assembly to share their lives together and to be faithful to each other until death parts them. But they won't be able to do this without your help. Therefore, we pray for their love to be strong enough. We ask for your blessing, for your helping and forgiving words. Please give them signs of your nearness when they need them. Give them your Holy Spirit who makes them wise. We pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. In these verses of Colossians chapter 3, love is compared with an overcoat, which is worn above all other pieces of clothing. That's why we talk about clothes today. You chose a special location for this special day. That's awesome. Everything is prepared and perfect. You're dressed very festively. And that's awesome. You, Margo, with your beautiful wedding dress. And you, Jay, with your fancy suit on. And probably all or most of the guests bought new clothes for this occasion. And this shows you how important this day is for them. And they express their appreciation for you. And look around, it's all for you.
Thank you.
But when this day is over, everyone puts his festive dresses back into the closet and put the workaday clothes on. And in your life, you need clothes which are suitable for all kind of occasions. And of course, I don't know what you have in your closet, but definitely you will find special outfits for hiking and rock climbing. For your job, you both need a uniform. Jay, you certainly wear a neat pilot uniform. And Margo, I suppose you wear the white doctor's uniform. And people, hopefully, can put their mind at rest because they know that they are in the best hands. On Sundays, you wear other clothes than in daily life. You have outfits for spare time and clothes, for example, for garden work. And the same applies to matrimony. You need a lot of skills if life together shall succeed. You already unsheathed some of these skills. At first, I want to mention your power of endurance. Margo, you made it with your difficult studies. And you, Jay, you got through the demanding apprenticeship as pilot. And furthermore, you both have a high degree of sense of responsibility. And that's what you need. No matter if patients or airline passengers are entrusted to you, you are responsible for many human lives. And finally, at your rock climbing tours, you learned to fully trust in each other. That's a precious capacity in your life as a couple. Power of endurance is necessary for your matrimony because there will be hard times, times when routine and boredom have crept in. When it would be much more simple to run away and leave it all behind. Then you need the constancy to stay and the will and the power to change this situation so that love will be rekindled. And I mentioned the sense of responsibility. You decided to stay together for your whole life. But it only works if both of you are willing to make compromises and not only to follow your own interests. And if you are willing to ask your partner how he or she feels about the situation or about a particular decision which was made. Sometimes responsibility means to put the partner's interest over the own interest. But now let's talk about confidence. A matrimony will never work if confidence is missing. Jay, for instance, uses to be away for 3 or 4 days a week. So what would you feel like, Margo, if you were not able to trust him? It must be horrible. Confidence. That means you can rely on your partner in every condition of life. Rely on his faithfulness, on his loyalty, and his honesty, even when it's uncomfortable. And above all, be willing to forgive another. Both of you are not perfect, and in the course of the years, you will figure out your partner's tics and bad habits and deficiencies. You will make mistakes. You will become guilty against each other. But if you are able to forgive, you won't be burdened. Otherwise, during your life, your burden will get much too heavy. So, don't act like the wife whose husband cried on his friend's shoulder. He moaned, "Every time we argue, my wife becomes historical." "You mean hysterical?" his friend wanted to correct him. No, the husband answered, "I mean historical. Because every time we have a dispute, my wife blames me for each mistake I've ever made in all the years of marriage." So don't do that. Yeah, all this sounds very ambitious. And indeed, it is. But the Word of God offers assistance so that the adventure, matrimony, will be successful. So we're gonna have the first part in German.
Dieser Vers aus dem dritten Kapitel des Kolosserbriefes vergleicht die Liebe mit einem Mantel, der über allen anderen Kleidern getragen wird. Deshalb wollen wir heute über Kleider reden. Liebe Margo, lieber Jay, ihr habt euch für diesen Tag festlich gekleidet. Du, Margo, in einem wunderschönen Brautkleid und du, Jay, in einem schicken Anzug.
Silber ist, werden die schönen Kleider in den Schrank gehängt und die Alltagskleider werden wieder angezogen. Ihr braucht in eurem Leben für jeden Anlass die passende Kleidung. Was in eurem Kleiderschrank so alles hängt, weiß ich nicht. Aber ich vermute, es ist auf jeden Fall Wander- und Kletterkleidung dabei. Und für die Arbeit braucht ihr ja beide Uniformen. Du, Jay, trägst bestimmt eine adrette Pilotenuniform. Margo, deine Berufskleidung als Ärztin. Und die Menschen sind hoffentlich beruhigt, wenn sie euch sehen, weil sie wissen, dass sie in den richtigen Händen sind. Ihr zieht euch am Sonntag anders als während der Woche. Ihr habt Freizeitkleidung und Kleidung, die Menschen oder Flugpassagiere anvertraut werden. Ihr tragt die Verantwortung für viele Menschenleben. Auf euren Klettertouren habt ihr gelernt, euch gegenseitig absolut zu vertrauen. Durchhaltevermögen ist in einer Ehe nötig, denn es
dann ist da noch das Vertrauen. Niemals wird eine Ehe gut gehen, wenn das Vertrauen zueinander fehlt. Jay ist zum Beispiel tagelang unterwegs. Wie würde es dir, Margo, gehen, wenn du ihm nicht vertrauen würdest? Vertrauen, das heißt auch, sich verlassen können auf den Partner, auf seine Treue, seine Loyalität, auf seine Ehrlichkeit, auch wenn sie manchmal unbequem sein kann. Darüber hinaus seid beide bereit, einander zu vergeben. Ihr seid beide nicht perfekt und ihr werdet im Laufe der Jahre immer Leid klagt. Immer wenn wir streiten, wird meine Frau historisch. Du meinst hysterisch, will sein Freund ihn verbessern. Darauf der Ehemann: Nein, ich meine schon historisch. Denn jedes Mal, wenn es Streit gibt, wirft meine Frau mir alle Fehler vor, die ich den ganzen Tag unserer Ehe gemacht habe.
All these virtues put on love. When I tell you, love you, you may probably think that's obvious that we love each other. Therefore, we are here. We want to share our life. No doubt, we can see that you are in love and that you are happy. And that's exactly how it should be. You're supposed to rejoice in each other. You're supposed to be happy and enjoy your life together. This was God's idea when He created love between male and female. God is not only the creator of love, but He takes a huge step ahead. John's first letter says,
God is love. And this divine love is boundless and selfless. The greatest proof of his love for the mankind is his son, Jesus Christ. In his person, God became a human being. He let Jesus die so that we, his beloved children, can live in freedom of sin and guilt. Therefore, human love has its anchor in the Lord's love to us. And your love is a reflection of the divine love, and therefore not selfish, but selfless. And so you let this love shine in your being and love each other. And you are, so to say, ambassadors of the Lord's love. But don't be afraid. That doesn't mean you have to give a delusion of a perfect life. This is exactly what true love doesn't include. Because there is no love without conflicts. Sometimes a dispute is unavoidable. In this case, all depends on how you settle the dispute. Do you settle the dispute selfish, or are you able to show respect? The Bible, God's love letter to mankind, is full of conflicts. It makes clear that it's impossible to live without them. To claim something else would be unrealistic. And sometimes a dispute for the sake of an issue is more honest than playing an artificial harmony. True love can handle this. This way your love to each other can be an example for God's love, for the people around you. On the one hand, that's high demand. But on the other hand, you know that God is love, and you don't have to generate it by yourself. This will bring certainty in your relationship. But not everything is up to you. Your Heavenly Father delights in helping you. Ask Him. He's just a prayer away from you. He enables you to be willing to forgive. The divine love is not cover up to hide true feelings, but God's embrace to His children, to you, Margo and Jay. His love never fails and will never forsake anyone. These bonds of love will hold you together all your life. That's true for the happy and the easygoing times, but all the more in the hard times. Therefore, I wish with all of my heart that you accept this unique offer of the Lord's love, that you take comfort in it, and that you're expecting everything that is humanly impossible from His love. Amen.
Sondern geht einen gewaltigen Schritt weiter. Dort steht, Gott ist die Liebe. Diese göttliche Liebe ist grundlos und selbstlos. Gottes größter Beweis seiner Liebe zu uns Menschen ist sein Sohn Jesus Christus. In ihm ist Gott Mensch geworden. Ihn hat
die Liebe nicht. Denn Liebe gibt es nicht ohne Konflikte. Manchmal ist ein Streit sogar unausweichlich. Doch dann wird alles davon abhängen, wie ihr diesen Streit austragt. Tragt ihr ihn egoistisch aus oder könnt ihr euch gegenseitig Achtung entgegenbringen? Dass Gott die Liebe ist und ihr euch an dieser Quelle bedienen könnt, könnt ihr auch gelassen sein, denn ihr wisst, es hängt nicht alles von euch alleine ab. Gott selbst macht euch fähig, besonnen und vergebungsbereit zu sein. Deshalb zieht über alles aber an die Liebe. Sie ist das Band, das euch zusammenhalten wird, euer Leben lang. In den leichten, unbeschwerten Zeiten, wie in den schweren.
God's chosen people, you are holy and dearly loved. So put on tender mercy and kindness as if they were your clothes. Don't be proud. Be gentle and patient. Put up with each other. Forgive the things that you are holding against one another. Forgive just as the Lord forgave you. And over all those good things, put on love. Love holds them all together perfectly as if they were one. Let the peace that Christ gives rule in your hearts. As parts of one body, you are appointed to live in peace and be thankful. Let Christ's word live in you like a rich treasure. Teach and correct each other wisely. Sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Sing with thanks in your hearts to God. Do everything you say or do in the name of the Lord Jesus. Always give thanks to God the Father through Christ.
Two are better than one, because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other one up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken.
God entrusts you to one another. He wants to shelter and to bless your matrimony with His grace. And you shall be living signs for God's love and faithfulness. So, give now the vows to each other.
Presence of God in this community.
I take you to be my
Jay, to be my husband,
to be my wife, Margo, to be my wife,
to have and hold from this day forward,
to have and to hold this day forward,
in joy and in sorrow,
in joy and in sorrow,
in plenty and in want,
in plenty and in want,
in sickness and in health,
sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
as long we both shall live,
as long as we both shall live.
So now give you the rings. Jay, you say Margo.
Margo? I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Jay.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Jay and Margo, by their promises before God and this and the presence of this assembly, have joined themselves to one another as husband and wife.
Joined together, let no one separate. Amen. So please sit down again. We want to have another music. God, creator of love, lead Margo and Jay to fullness of life. In joy, give them thankfulness. In conflict, the willingness to forgive. And love, which grows and matures. Bless them so that their matrimony may be witness to your love. Bless them in their work and companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. So the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen.
Now, the prayer of intercession. Almighty God, so often we exclude your presence out of our lives. We forget that our life can be successful without your help and your grace. Please remind us that without your solid foundation, our love is built on sand. Therefore, we pray for all couples, especially for Margo and Jay. Give them patience and mutual trust, strength and courage to move towards to another and to keep talking to one another in situations of conflict. We pray for all those whose matrimony has failed. Let them forgive one another so that they are able to reshape their life. Good God, we pray for all who suffer from disease. Give them patience and hope. We pray for all whose partners or family members pass away. Take them in your loving arms and comfort them. We pray for peace for those who suffer from war and terror. Give the responsible politicians the will to stop war. Your Son, Jesus Christ, showed us how to love, to forgive, and to be merciful. We belong to Him today, tomorrow, and in eternity. So, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Peace of Christ will be with you always. Sam.
And also with you.
Dear Margo and Jay, I have a present for you.
May I come to you?
Okay. Please take this Holy Bible as a gift. The Holy Script is the base on which we can lead our matrimony, which you can lead your matrimony. In God's Word, you can find words of help, words of forgiveness, and words of praise. The words of God can teach you how to love each other with a love that is stronger than human will. So use this Bible like a map, like you do it on your hikes. It will always lead you the right way. Now you may kiss the bride. So please stand up for the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turns His face toward you and give you peace. Amen. And for the first time, may I introduce you Mr. and Mrs. Jay Corbett.
Bite your tongue.
That would be tough.
Martin, mir schwanke zu alt.
Das ist kein Gott.
Das
smart. They're like, we're getting out of here now.
This metallic part, open it and put it on the second level. Trento? S'il vous plaît?
This is the hard part, right?
It's the hardest part.
That's the hard part.
Okay.
Okay, here he goes.
One, two, three.
So first I take the,
yeah,
the wrapper off.
Then wrap her off and throw it on the ground.
On the ground. On the ground. On the ground. On the ground.
Yeah, you're learning fast.
Okay, on the ground. On the
ground. And insurance. Really important. From the second step on the first step.
Alright.
This is the hard step.
That makes sense.
That is the difficult part.
Why are we doing this?
Yeah. Because if you cut it, yes, it could break. But if you hold it together, it won't break. Yeah. Do you have to close it again? Yes.
Yeah.
scene. The scene.
The back. And on the line,
we can't see.